Thanks for watching. I'm meteorologist Jacqueline Thomas. Of course, heading towards the end of the week, all eyes on an incoming storm bringing some alert weather across New Hampshire, mainly in the form of snow. And we're talking about a plowable snow, especially across central and northern parts of the state where several inches of snow is expected. As you head a little further south and east, we'll likely see snow to a mix and rain right along the immediate coast. But as we head overnight Friday into Saturday, we could actually see a changeover back to snow, even for those parts of the state. Either way, high travel impact expected, especially later on Friday. So if you are going to be traveling at all these next few days, Thursday looks good. We're going to stay dry during the day tomorrow. Even Thursday evening should still be okay, but there may be an isolated snow shower or sprinkle out ahead of the main part of this system, which moves in late Thursday night, overnight into Friday. High impacts expected for travel throughout the day on Friday. And then even into Saturday, there could be some lingering impacts, especially through the first half of the day as we continue to see some lingering snow showers. So satellite and radar remains quiet through the rest of the night tonight. If you're heading out and about this evening, great night to maybe do some shopping. Just got to bundle up. It's a little chilly. And then a wider look shows that we've got some more action off to our south and west. And this is all going to be tracking eastward, and eventually some low pressure develops here off the coast. And that's what's going to bring us the potential for the snow that we're talking about. So here's what that looks like through the day tomorrow. We stay quiet. We get into some sunshine, especially early in the day, but the clouds will thicken up as the day goes on. And I expect by the end of the day, we're going to see a mainly cloudy sky. And then there could be a little bit of showery activity right along the coast, a rain shower, a sprinkle, and then even a snow shower or flurry possible a little further inland out ahead of this storm. And this all moves in overnight into Friday morning. So as you wake up Friday, if you're stepping out the door early, you'll likely see some snow coming down, especially away from the coast. Now, this is going to continue to push its way across the state. So far north, it might take just a little bit longer to really see that snow come down. But once it does, you'll be seeing snow for the duration of this event and the duration of this storm system. Notice, though, this thin pink line that is indicating that mixing line, that changeover from snow to rain. The rain, of course, here in green, that snow in the purplish blue. So as you head further south and east towards the coast, generally south or east of Manchester, that's where you're going to see rain and that changeover to a mix. But you head north and west of the Queen City and you're likely dealing with mainly snow as the precipitation type. Now notice as Friday goes on, by Friday evening, that line starts to creep its way further south and east. And so even as you head closer to the coast, you could end up with some accumulating snow. And then Friday night into Saturday, we end up with some colder air moving in behind the system, and that could lead to a changeover to snow showers even as you head towards the coast as well. So depending how long this lingers into Saturday and how that changeover occurs, that's all what we're keeping an eye on here as we head through these next couple of days, because any shift in the track of this too could impact what we see as far as precipitation type and therefore what we see as far as snow totals. But for now, here's our thinking and here's what we've got. According to an inch as you head southeast in the state, right along the shore, that's where you're mainly going to stay rain. But then Manchester now, about 1 to 3 inches there. Concord now in that 3 to 6 inch range, and that extends all the way up towards Plymouth. Notice the pink bullseye here across parts of the Monadnock region. That is where you could see 6 to 12 inches of snow, and another bullseye as you head through the Northern Lakes region and across parts of the White Mountains. That's where you're also going to see some higher snowfall totals. So this is what we've got. Stay tuned. Of course, keep checking back for any changes that may occur over the next day or two out ahead of the storm. But in the meantime, until it gets here, we're pretty quiet. The winds continue to die down tonight, lows in the 20s and teens tomorrow, back in the upper 30s, near 40 degrees for a high. So pretty pleasant overall on Thursday, not nearly as gusty either. And we do see some sunshine initially, but then the clouds quickly take over. Certainly, I think more clouds for southern parts of the state. And then all eyes on that system impact weather as we head into the weekend, alert weather for Friday. But we continue to see those impacts even into Saturday as that snow lingers. And then the second half of the weekend, not too bad. It turns breezy and bright, and heading into next week, a quiet start, and certainly going to be cold as we approach the official start of winter.